Hi there. So Realme was on a spree releasing new products today, and frankly, many of them were really interesting. But about that later, I'm here to talk about the newly launched Realme 55-inch SLED TV. Oh my god, so much hype. Of course, I'll tell you about its specs and things that Realme didn't tell you about it at the launch event. But first, we'll start with the specs we know. Cortex A55 quad-core CPU, Mali 470 GPU, 4K display panel with a resolution of 3840 by 2160 pixels, 1.5 GB RAM with 16 GB storage, Android TV 9 OS with 24 watt sound output. Alright, let's start with what's good. First, the CPU. A55 Cortex CPU, great. 4K display panel, amazing. Android TV 9 OS, perfect. All the apps you need, Netflix, Prime Videos, YouTube, Disney Hotstar, super amazing. Dual band Wi-Fi, which is always good. Then the highlight, the SLED. SLED is an RGB backlight that passes through a series of filters like liquid crystal, TFT glass, and color filters to give you more vibrant images. Along with that, it also comes with TUV reinfilled low blue light certification, which basically means it protects your eyes from the blue light that TVs emit. So that's actually a really good part. But then there were a lot of things that Realme didn't address. First, the 1.5 GB RAM. Now this is really disappointing. No 55-inch 4K Android TV I've seen has less than 2 GB RAM. I have the 55-inch Toshiba TV that has 1.5 GB RAM, but that is a Linux-based software, not Android. In a time where we want more RAM, this is just too less. I'm sure it must be well optimized, but still too less. Moving on, 400 nits brightness, which is okay, but not the best. Even the Nokia TV that was launched yesterday has 450 nits brightness, which it's definitely kind of a norm now. You need more brightness to push that kind of content. Anyway, then the Realme TV also doesn't have Dolby Vision support. However, HDR10 is there. Contrast ratio is just 4000:1. Again, decent but not the best. The Nokia TV 55-inch has 5000:1. The reason I'm comparing the Nokia TV with the Realme TV is that both are priced between 40 and 43,000 and are just newly released products. No micro dimming also on the Realme TV, which the Nokia TV has. This is actually becoming like a comparison video, but actually I don't want to compare, but I'm just trying to compare that something that was just launched with better specs is cheaper. And what is surprising is this is an SLED, still no micro dimming. Anyway, only 24 watt down firing speakers. Most 55 inch TVs are coming with at least 30 watt. And coming back to Nokia TV, you get 48 watt Onkyo built-in soundbar with that. That's literally double, and that too Onkyo. There are a lot of things that don't work in my opinion for the Realme TV. SLED is probably the only saving grace, but that again, we have not tested it yet. But lower RAM, lesser brightness, and poor sound output are big reasons to think twice. In fact, check out the Nokia TV. It's even cheaper, $39,999. The Realme TV was announced for $42,999, but the price on Flipkart is $39,999. Nokia's biggest drawback is single band Wi-Fi. Rest, it has much more to offer in specs compared to the Realme TV. I'm totally disappointed with the Realme TV, no doubt about that, just too much hype. It might have a good display, but not enough juice to compel anyone to buy it. I'll recommend you wait and watch a couple of review videos before you take a plunge. So this was it guys, short video, I just wanted to put my point about the Realme TVs. I hope this video is helpful. Write down in the comments if you have any questions. I'll leave the links also below for the Realme TV. If you'd like to check it out, you can go through that. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Until next time, cheers. Audio Jungle.